Good morning once more and welcome on board another edition of the papers on Canal de English. My name is Lesley Fombuh and I'm delighted to be your guest this morning. We unveil the paper this morning with The Sun that captions on a very interesting story. Abdoulaye Babale calls for teamwork at Elecam, that is the elections watchdog in Cameroon. The details on the story says the newly installed officials of Elections Cameroon, Elecam, have been called upon to promote team spirit at work in order to enable the elections management body meet up with the numerous challenges to perfect Cameroon's electoral system. The story says the call was made last October 21 by the Director General of Elections, Abdoulaye Babale, as he officially commissioned the 24-man team, that they were 7 women and 17 men, during a solemn ceremony he chaired at the Yaoundé City Council Hall in the presence of the Ministry of Economy, Planning and Regional Development, Yauba Abdoulaye. The story says the Mfundi Senior Divisional Officer, Jean-Claude Tila, Vice President of the National Communication Council, Peter Isokam, and some members of the Electoral Board of Elecam. We stay with The Sun this morning that captions on another interesting story that has been attracting the papers in the course of the week. The story says that thousands scramble for sports at the National Advanced PNT School. The details on the story says the following official launching of the competitive entrance examination into the various training cycles of the National Advanced School of Post and Telecommunications recently by a joint ministerial decision of the Ministers of Post and Telecommunications and Higher Education. Thousands of applicants have converged on the Yaoundé Unique Center to deposit the application documents as the deadline of October 28, that is today, draws near. We look at the CAN, that is the African Cup of Nations, 2016-2019. Minister, the Sun says that the minister gives a road company's 8-month deadline. Details on the story says the minister of Housing and Urban Development, Jean-Claude Mbwenchu, has urged contractors, energy engineers and technicians in charge of the construction roads to make sure that the stadiums are present, ready before it's time. We also focus on the Le Messager, which captions on what the papers are called Cameroonians who are brilliant at the international scene. The story zooms on acting president of FIFA, Issa Yatou, Celestine Monga, Keremuna, Kalkaba Malboum, Kodo Dang. You can read more of that story on page 4 of Le Messager. Le Messager also captions on a sensitive story saying that the syndicate of transporters has announced a strike action for next month. Details on the story says the syndicate of transporters is disgruntled with the price of fuel. You can quench your thirst for more information on page 3 of Le Messager this morning. On page 9, Le Messager says 13 towns in Cameroon will soon have from a permanent and a continuous supply of potable water. Details on the story says the Kingdom of Belgium is supporting the project with the sum of 26 million francs CFA. Another paper, Le Popoli, says Samuel Etofis might have bought the Cameroon embassy in the United States of America. Details on the story says the embassy was going through serious problems before the striker decided to buy it. The former Indomitable Lion striker Samuel Etofis is said to have bought the building and renovated it. Le Financier d'Afrique this morning captions on the Cameroon Railway Corporation saying the company has invested 180 million francs CFA in 15 years. You can read more of that story on Le Financier d'Afrique this morning. Another paper, La Détente, this morning says Jeremy Njita has bought over the Fotso Empire. Details on the story says the former Indomitable Lion striker recently acquired a reasonable share of the property and family members are presently daggers drawn in courts in Banjul. La Nouvelle Expression this morning captions on the reorganization of basic organs of the Cameroon People's Democratic Party, Movement Party, on its banner. You know, the papers in the course of this week have been focusing on that story. When money goes against the instructions of President Paul Biya, you can read more on page 10 of La Nouvelle Expression this morning. Well, televiewers, we are glad to know you were there watching the very first part of the program this morning. Like we told you, you're watching the papers on Canal de English. In the first part of the program, we give you what the papers say. And the second part, we comment on the contents of the newspapers today. And I'm receiving my senior colleague, Kejang Henry. You're welcome.
Thank you very much, Lesley Fombuh.
Yes, good morning. You know, that's a name people have not discovered. I'm glad to have you on board the show.
It's my pleasure.
Yes, you've been going through the papers this morning. What actually caught your attention?
Well, one big story, I'm frightened, is the transporters syndicate that is preparing to embark on a strike action. You should understand, remember what happened in 2008, and the where Cameroonians went for 4 days, you know, they were indoors because people mistook what a strike action is. And the fact actually brandished that 2008 strike action hunger strike because there's no hunger strike.
Yes, but it all started with fuel prices, I think.
Of course, that because fuel prices went up and the transporters could not, you know, contain the seismic repercussions caused by, you know, the price hike. Now, in another way, the market prices went up for commodities, basic commodities, and so the transporters ask the government to give, you know, to reverse the situation. That is why, you know, people now had to be triggered, because when the prices went up, there was news of maybe a small increase in the salary of the pay package.
Yes.
And so prices went up, prices skyrocketed in the commodity market, in the market. Now they are saying that they may go on a strike by the end of, this is the end of the year.
Yes.
And you understand that at the end of the year, it's a period where people have to do good, brisk business. So I'm afraid powers that be, the authority, should start looking into this thing, negotiate with those people before, you know, things go worse.
Well, the point is that we know the syndicate of transporters has been threatening the government for a very long time, but nothing is happening. Maybe some of them have been bribed, and then when they announce a strike action like this, it's not the first time they are doing that.
It is not like being bribed.
Yes.
You know that transporters are going through a very delicate period now.
Yes.
You know, carrying goods, because when we talk of transporters, we are not just talking about, you know, just interurban or intra-urban, that is just limited within Cameroon. These people go right up to Central African Republic, right up to Chad. And you know, with the security challenges, it becomes so difficult. And you know, they have a deadline to submit their goods. They have a deadline because, in fact, it's business. When they're transporting goods from Cameroon, serving landlocked Chad, serving landlocked Central African Republic. Now, it is important that the government dialogues with these people rather than allowing them to go on a strike action, you know, maybe for one day. You know, can imagine what the government will be losing or the country will be losing in case, you know, these people sit down for 1 day or 2 days. And you can imagine the what was evaluated as general loss, you know, during the 2008, you know, call it hunger strike action, but it was not hunger strike action, industrial strike action for the transport sector. It was enormous for the GDP. So it is important that the government starts discussing with this industry.
And why not bring down the fuel prices?
Well, in fact, that will be determined, you know, because normally the government has to subvent. That will be determined by the forces of, you know, the market forces. And know that presently we are talking about, I got it from Le Financier d'Afrique.
Yes.
Where the government, in fact, sub-Saharan African countries now are about 3.8% growth rate, which is not good. And they're making projections for 4.4 by 2016 and 4.8 by 2017, meaning that if the government, you know, has to dialogue, if the government has to subvent, if the government has to, you know, put in breaking mechanisms to arrest the situation, it might be better.
Yes, let's look at another focus today on the papers. We had, the reorganization of the basic organs of the Cameroon People's Democratic Movement nowadays is making news. And La Nouvelle Expression this morning said that some of the party bigwigs and even some militants of the party might be going against the instructions of the President of the Republic, who is the national president, because of money. The story says, when money goes against the instructions of the President of the Republic.
Well, you understand it's
dangerous.
Yes, it's dangerous, Lesley. Remember, there has been massive vaccination at the level of the, you know, when I say vaccination, I mean vaccination from the functions.
Yes.
You know, those who were tipped as resource persons to go or, you know, follow up the reorganization, resign from that function to go pick up what some call juicy, you know, function as presidents of sections and so on. Now, the money might change hands, but at whose detriment? Now, somebody who is probably bribing his way to become the party bigwig at the grassroots level, he should certainly know that he or she will not come out, because when they will go and sit on the negotiating on the table and say, okay, Mr. Fombuh Lesley bribed to become the chairman or the president of the subsection or section, Mr. Kejan bribed to become the president of the BLM section, it becomes detrimental. And when it's like that, it becomes a problem. Now, don't forget that the Musongo committee is still on. You know, when I talk of the Musongo committee, I'm talking about the committee that is in charge of discipline within the party. Now, these are, I suppose Mr. Jean Kwete is taking note of all these things. And at the end of the process, they might now go on the drawing board and say, okay, Mr. Lesley, you are coming from Mankon. You were voted, and you were voted based on this, that. And then they will start slamming, you know, sanctions on some of those people. I think they're allowing it to go. But at the end of the day, probably sanctions will follow.
I know you are very conversant with issues in the Southwest region when it comes to the CPDM party. Yesterday, the Sun said that there is a problem too at the level of Boya, where, you know, our strongman Bella Muki is trying to make sure that things happen for him. And he actually said that ill-gotten wealth mongers might be trying to grab the major post of that party.
Well, that is...
And the caption was, Boya CPDM reorganization goes nasty.
Yes, it is. It has been nasty from the beginning, because can you imagine that when former Prime Minister Peter Mafani Musonge called the elites of his place, in his residence, asking that some mayors of FACO, some parliamentarians, some big wigs should not stand for the election.
Yes.
It was already a problem. Now, Mayor Nkeng Michael of Buyuka Council, Mayor Esunge of Boya, and some other persons were against that decision, because they said they should come with a consensual list.
Yes.
Now, but they said, no, this is an election. This is a reorganization. Why will we not stand? Don't forget that Mr. Bella Muki, Senator Bella Muki, has a hand that is full with functions. He is the...
And connections.
No, forget about the connections. He is one of the Feka Foot, scribe.
Yes.
He is a
senator.
A senator. He is still the president of the section. He is still the president of the section, because, you know, the race is to replace Bella Muki as of now in Boya.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, in the section.
Is it possible to beat him there?
Well, when the time comes, in fact, if they pay the count, why not? It was possible. He was beaten during the last election.
Yes.
And Mayor Esunga is the mayor. It is not, sorry, he was not beaten, rather, because he stepped down.
Yes.
Because he wanted to move into the Senate. Mm-hmm. Right? Now he stepped down because he wanted to move into the Senate. So why would you think that he would not be beaten?
Presently, we are going to see a real game now.
Now, the real match is coming, because, in fact, the camps are divided. In fact, Boya is nasty now when it comes to CBDM politics. Now the Musonge Mujowa committee that was set up, you know, to come up with a consensual list is facing already challenges, stiff resistance from those who think that they should stand for the election. And remember, when John Gute went to Bamenda to reorganize elections or to oversee, he told the chiefs, the funds and the chiefs, the first class, that you are not going to stand, sir. You will not stand. And some bears were quarreling with him, asking why. Now, them bears, I know they say it's a juicy post. They were saying that third class chiefs would stand and so on. And why would they stand? Now, they made them to understand third class chiefs don't have statues and they are quarter heads. So they can stand. Those are the people at the grassroots. You are an elitist. The phone is not a grassroots person. So they made it clear to them that don't stand for the elections.
There's another big story, Kejang Henry, that the number one striker, one-time number one striker of Cameroon, Samuel Tofis, might have bought over the Cameroon embassy in the United States of America. That is on Lopopoli this morning, because the embassy was going through problems. What do you say about this kind of journalism? Is it investigative? Are we sure of this?
Well, don't forget that Lopopoli is a satirical journal. Mm-hmm. It might be a gag. Popoli just had to set an agenda. It might be a gag.
Is there any smoke without fire?
Someone it is buying over Cameroon's embassy. Yes, Cameroon embassy has a problem, and there have been many write-ups on the problems plaguing Cameroon's embassy. Do you know that it is said that Cameroon embassy has no telephone?
In the USA, of course.
Do you know that it is said that Cameroon embassy in the US of A is leaking, has leaking roofs? Do you know that the telephone lines are not working? These are the things that are...
So Lopopoli is not far
from the truth.
Yes.
Now, whether or not Samuel Tofis is going to buy up Cameroon's embassy,
it's another issue. Maybe buy the building. Yes, has already bought the building, renovated it, and handed it back to the Cameroon government.
But if Samuel renovates the building,
yes,
for the sake of his country, that is a big thing he has done for his country. But if Samuel Tofis renovates it and gives it back to the country, it means it is a shame to the government. And I think the new Minister of External Relations, Le Jeune Bellamy, I think where he was living in Paris as Cameroon's ambassador to France is 150 times better than where the Cameroon's ambassador to the U.S. is living.
Well, they say there's no smoke without fire. When you look at the drawings on Lopopoli this morning, it's actually funny. You find a Samuel Tofis who is handing over the keys to a government official,
certainly for Cameroon. That is a mockery to say that we abandoned our embassy.
Yes.
In dilapidated conditions, no telephone. The water system is not flowing. In fact, the closets are blocked. There is no. In fact, we got information that. Water is not running in our embassy in the US of A. Some areas don't have light. Some part of archive departments abandoned. Telephone lines are not working. And it became a problem. Therefore, they are owing, debt to, embassy workers in the US of A.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not a big surprise that our Cameroon's embassy, in fact, part of the roof is leaking. And you can imagine documents have been damaged, et cetera, et cetera. Mm-hmm.
So if sort of thing is happening, Kejang Henry, what should be done to resolve it? Because it's a negative image to the country.
No, I'm not in the decision-making position, but let me just tell you that
it
is incumbent on the Minister of External Relations to take
note
of all
because
these
it's
things.
Like Samuel Tofis has done something bad when you look at the story.
No, it is ironical because it is just Popoli is doing that to tell the country that it's a shame.
Mm-hmm.
It is a shame that you cannot refurbish, you cannot innovate your embassy. In fact, the embassy, we learned from previous reports that it is not having, in fact, they were formerly, I don't know if, I've not seen the pictures of the renovated building.
Mm-hmm.
There were no paints. The building was nasty, it's dirty, etc. So we got this information.
Well, thank you very much, Kejang Henry, for respecting this rendezvous.
It's my pleasure.
We know you have a very busy schedule, but you had to find some time to be here.
We will always be here.
Thanks, televiewers out there, for watching another edition of the program, The Papers on Canal de English. We promise you another interesting package for tomorrow. Thanks for your kind attention once more, and goodbye.